Hey everybody, welcome back. Second video. Those of you that checked us out for the first video, we were looking at something more classic rock. Today I'm going to share something a little different. I can pretty much guarantee, Dad, that you've never heard anything by this group before. I can pretty much guarantee it. So this is G Love and Special Sauce. You ever heard of G Love and Special Sauce?
Can't say that I have.
I've actually got one of my G Love shirts on.
Huh. So all it says is love.
All it says is love. That's right. But I got it from a G Love concert. This guy, he's from Philadelphia. And I first heard him at a music festival, actually in Columbia, Missouri. Roots, blues, and music or something. And never heard of him before. Ended up at that stage and was like, okay, this is awesome. I love this. And I think I've seen him in concert 3 times since then. Every time he comes through, I go see it. Super fun. Anyway, his brand of music, he calls hip hop blues. So back to my point before in a previous video, you know, like, one of my missions is to see if there's some form of hip hop that you would actually enjoy. So I'm going to play a song called Blues Music by G Love. And I don't know if it'd be useful for you. You can't really hear very well. You could pull up the lyrics on your computer if that would be useful. It's not a horrible idea. Or you could just listen to it. What are you doing over there?
Listening.
Okay. I guess that means you're ready.
I should throw in maybe at this point that there's a lot of songs that my reaction to it, whether I like it or not, has nothing to do with the lyrics. I don't know what the lyrics are. All I know is I like the song, the music.
Well, I must have gotten that from you because I can listen to music a million times and I still have no idea what the heck they're saying. Okay. And it doesn't really bother me. Somebody in my office brought that up just yesterday. I had some music on in the background and she was commenting on the lyrics. And I was like, oh, wow. Like, I've never even noticed the lyrics. I probably heard that song 100 times, you know. Okay, so here we go. This is Blues Music by G Love and Special Sauce. All right.
G Love and Special Sauce.
G Love and Special Sauce. Here it goes.
Bound, we all must agree. We like to get groovy with the sounds of the old time. We like to jam, cause man, sound from the bandstand, hand from the cosmic, hang from the old ones, the tones, the gears, the props, and the ride. Very much simple, chill it outside. Way back, way back. From where music really started, I'm a child of the 80s. Somewhere I departed, and since then I started a collection of the people who started it all. I reckon, therefore, I kept them in my side like mine. Blues music. Blues music. It's all about rocking the van, not rocking. rock to roll, but sway to sway. Shots work out of lay. Yo, what that fly girl Sabine say, Jay. About 8 miles to the garden, that's some highway setting. That's a cool, cool lounge in Atlantic City bound in 1920 to the 1970s. A shame with some pool. Hoes, yo, some Eddie, get ready real cool, cool, cool. To earth and side, cat, hi-hat, dope, dope, road, Daryl strings, my things, the bass where I sat. Yeah. Let the rhyme bang. The tense of the time of the old time. Blues, blues, I blues. Blind Lemon Jefferson and Zeus BMWs. The Fruit Force, the Abacana, Booker White, Booker T, James Brown. Jimmy Smith at the console, a soul with the girls. Aretha, Shaka Khan, the soul solid gold. Cisco and Sonny and La Belly too. People's the road with Woody and you, Bob Dylan. A million sears, silver tone. Guitars, heard the legs. Yo, Looney, take them nowhere. Blues music. It's like chewing gum with your headphones on, like drinking lemonade. Chilling on the front porch after running ball. Like you lost a $20 bill, like I got a free ticket, yo, from the scratch and win. It's like the swimsuit issue. Yeah, I think I need a tissue. It's like you and your baby got nasty, cut off and left alone. Now making eyes on the city bus again. Now you got ink spots on your page again. Grandma cooks a blueberry pie. Little sister got a boyfriend, yeah. It's like smoking the right, the final rights, the vinyl rides. Blues music.
What?
That one does nothing for me.
Nothing?
Well, maybe a one.
One was the bottom of the scale. That was the bottom of the scale.
Okay, so 0.6 would be off the scale.
Yeah, one to 10 is the scale.
Okay, then one.
Wow. That's it?
Yeah. The same thing holds true with me for music that holds true with movies. Once in a while, there's a song or a movie that I have to experience several times and allow it to grow on me. So it's possible that if I heard that song a few more times over a period of time, it might grow on me. But my first impression is,
I mean, I'm not totally surprised, but you know, I thought it's got kind of a groovy rhythm, you know, and I like the drums. It's got a little bit of a jazzy, kind of a bluesy feel to it.
Yeah.
A one. Oh, well, like I said, I'm not super surprised. I mean, maybe a one. I'm a little surprised at a one, but I didn't expect it to be above the 5-point mark. So
one is never want to hear it again, right?
Yeah, and that's what you said. Okay. You gave it a one.
I should qualify that then and make it, I don't know, 1.5.
Wow. That's generous.
I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings or anything. You
know. Okay, so I'm going to consider that a failure. And But I'm not going to give up on the hip hop thing. There's still, I've still got some other hip hop ish things up my sleeve. So, and again, anybody paying attention to this, if you've got some thoughts, so anybody watching this, I can pretty much guarantee that my dad is not going to like any of the current sort of hip hop rap, not likely at all. However, I'm thinking of stuff like certain kinds of Beastie Boys, maybe. I'm saying this to anybody watching this in case you've got some thoughts. Or maybe like Diggable Planets, where, you know, it's got that jazz kind of vibe. But I don't know. So if anybody has any brilliant ideas, let me know. Let us know. I mean, the other thing that I've noticed is that, and so I'm thinking about this with the rap stuff, is that you do like certain songs that tell a story.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You know, there's certain Bob Dylan songs I know you like. Drive Me to Drinking, if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln.
Yeah.
You know, songs like that, right? Where there's like a story, like it's telling a story.
Well, and it's more spoken than sung. So does that qualify as rap?
Well, see, that's what's weird, right? Because there are certain kinds of some of those spoken things so what about Bob Dylan's Subterranean Homesick Blues?
Right. And what's the Johnny Cash one I'm trying to think of? I've Been Everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of rap-ish, right?
Well, in a general sense.
Okay.
I mean, you know, there's no doing the wreck turntable thing or...
You're making yourself sound old.
I am. I am old, and there's things that they do in music and movies and art that just do not compute. And for me, most hip hop rap falls into that category.
All right, audience, we've got our work cut out for us. We've got to find something that we can get him on board with. It's a little bit more modern and rap hip hop ish. I've got a couple of ideas. We'll see what we can come up with. There's Homer in the background. I guess we couldn't use him as some sort of a tortoise meter.
Whether he stays and listens or walks away.
Yeah. We'll call today's experiment a failure. G Love special sauce. Sorry, guys. I love you. My dad, not so much. But that's okay because he won't buy your stuff or come to your concerts anyway. But I will.
And maybe we've introduced a whole new bunch of new viewers or listeners to them.
There you go. So in that
people
way, we
buy their albums or go to their concerts.
Yeah. If we could ever go back to concerts again. All right, cool. Any last words?
No.